Hi everybody, thanks again for coming back to 1MinuteDigital.com. Today's a little bit longer tutorial, or advanced. It's nothing really advanced, it's just it takes a little more time to explain these things, but this is really basic, and I'm going to show you how to make type in a circle to create a round logo. Now a lot of you probably played with the type on a path tool, type on a circle, and it works, but it just doesn't look good, and it takes a little bit of doing to get it to do what you want, so I'm going to show you today how to do this. Okay, so I'm going to move this aside, and we're going to start from scratch. On your toolbar, select the ellipse tool. It defaults to the rectangle tool. Select the ellipse tool, and click anywhere on your artboard. And I'm going to start with a 5 by 5 inch circle. Again, with it still selected, click anywhere on the artboard, and make a 4 by 4 inch circle. Okay, and click anywhere on the artboard. I'm going to make a 3.5 by 3.5 inch circle. Now, select them all, and we have a bunch of blobby circles together. We're going to get rid of that fill and just make it a stroke, so now you can see all the circles. What we need to do is get them aligned so they're exactly one on top of another in sort of centered. So selecting all of them, go up to the top, and you have your selection tools up here. These are the bunch of shapes with the lines next to them, and that will help you distribute the circles evenly so they're one on top of another. So go to the box that starts right before those shapes start, click and hold, and make sure Align to Selection is selected. It defaults to Align to Artboard. Make sure it says Align to Selection. And then browse through here and click on the shapes that are in the center. Here's the horizontal Align Center. Click there. And you can see it put them all together horizontally. And now keep looking and find your vertical Align Center. Click that one, and now they're perfectly in place, one on top of another. And that's the way we want them. Now, if you can see in the finished version here, there's an outer circle, there's the type on a circle, and there's an inner circle where the star is. So that's these three circles here. Our type is going to go on that center circle. So with that selected, with your white arrow, we need to cut this line, this circle rather, in half. And you can do that by selecting your scissors tool. Now, look on your toolbar till you find your eraser. That's the default. Click and hold and select the scissors tool, little scissors icon there. And now I'm going to zoom in a little bit, and we're going to have to cut this circle in half. Click there, and then on the other side, click right where that little white box is and click there. And what that did, if you use your white arrow, is it cut that circle into the top half and the bottom half, which is perfect. That's what we want. Now, with that circle selected with your white arrow tool, click on your type tool, and we're going to work on the top part now. So hover over there until you see that sort of squiggly line. Click anywhere, and now we're going to start typing. So we're going to say make type in a circle, because that's what's going to go on top. Great, but it's small and it's not centered and it looks weird. So select it, and then go to Window, Type, Character. And let's make it bigger, just kind of bump up that font size a little bit till it gets to be the size that you want. Oops. And that looks good. I think that's a good enough size. It's not in the center though. So over here on your white arrow, when you click on there, you'll see you get this like white box with some handles. There's a handle in the center and then there's another handle over here. What we want to do is click that handle, not in the white box, but click on that handle and drag it till it gets to this where that line started. And now that line is there and that line is there, and now you can see your type is in the center. If it's not, go up here to your paragraph tools. It might be on Align Left or Align Right. We want to make sure it's in the center. So now it's perfectly where we want it to be. Now we want to do the bottom line. So click on there with your white arrow. Go over here to your type tool. Click anywhere and start typing. I'm going to say to make a circular, I think I spelled that wrong, logo. And as you've probably noticed, all that type disappeared. It's still there, but it doesn't show because it's designed to go this way instead of the way we want it to go. Don't worry about that. Again, go over to your white arrow until you get these weird little handles, the white box with the handles. Click that handle and drag it over to the where that line starts. And I did spell it wrong. Circular logo. And that is too many words to fit on that line, so it makes them disappear again. So what you want to do is click here and select everything and go up to your character palette, and you're going to have to bump it down a little bit till everything fits there. And there you go, we just bumped it down one font size, and now everything fits there to make a, circular. It's hard to read upside down, I don't know. Now we can bump it back up probably and it'll be fine. There we go. Okay, so now we have our type in a circle perfectly aligned, but design-wise, I think it's much better when you're making a circular logo to have your type read left to right on the top and on the bottom, so people don't break their necks trying to read the rest of your words here. So what we need to do in that case is select that again with your white arrow, go up to Type, Type on a Path, Type on a Path Options. That brings up a box here. The first thing you want to do is select Preview so we can see the changes that we're making to this line. Now, obviously the first thing you do is just flip it. We want to flip it so it reads left to right, and there we go. It does. It flipped it. It reads left to right, but it's weird. It squished all the letters together and it cut some of them off. Now you have to play with some of the rest of the settings. Right now, by default, the type is aligned to the baseline. Play with some of the rest of them, and you'll find ascender, descender, center, and baseline, and you'll find the one that you want. Ascender is perfect. Say OK. And there we go. Now it reads left to right on the top and left to right on the bottom. But as you might notice, they're not exactly aligned. If we click here with the white arrow, we can see that the bottom of the letter forms are kissing that baseline. They're right on that blue line there in Illustrator. If we click on the bottom, you can see that they're a little bit away from that baseline, and they're pushing out more towards that outer circle. You can fix that by going back to your character palette and finding your baseline shift tool, and that's the big A with the little A and the arrow underneath. Just bump it a few points up, 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 until it hits that line and kisses it just like the other one. In this case, it's about 6 points. And now, if you select both of them, you can see that the type is exactly aligned. The bottom of the top is hugging the baseline, and the top of the bottom is hugging the baseline, if that makes any sense. So that's perfect. The only thing we have to do now is spice it up a little bit and make it look like a logo. So clicking on that outer circle, let's give it a fill. Let's give it a nice red fill. Ooh, that is very bold. And for the stroke, clicking on the stroke in your toolbar, we're going to go to Window, Stroke, and that'll bring up your stroke options. Let's just make it a nice thick stroke to make it a bold logo, and I think that looks good. You also have the option here for your stroke alignment to align to the center, to the inside, or to the outside. Inside pushes it in a little bit close. Outside, I think, is perfect, and that is a good shape, I think, and a good thickness for that stroke. Okay, that's great. Now we have the inside. Clicking on that inside circle over here in your toolbar, let's make it not a stroke, but just a solid fill. There we go. Now it's just solid black and starting to look a lot more like a logo. Now let's put that star in the center, and you can use anything. I'm just using this for demonstration, but you can put a picture, illustration, anything you want. That is your logo. Over here on your ellipse tool, click and hold till you find the star tool. And now I'm going to zoom out a little bit. And holding down Shift, click and drag a star. That just keeps it standing straight up and not kind of flipping all over the place. So click and drag till you get a good size star off the artboard there. Let's make it white and drag it over here. A little bit big. Let's make it a little bit smaller. Put it in the center there. And I think that's a good size. Let's get another star. Holding down Shift, click and drag a little small one. Move it over there to fill in that space. Now do Edit, Copy, or Command C, and Edit, Paste in Place, or Shift Command V. Deselect it, then holding down Shift, click and drag, and that drags that copy over and it stays in alignment with the rest of it. And there we go, it's starting to look a lot like a logo now, but I think maybe this needs a fill. So select this one, hold down Shift, select the other one, and back in our, actually go over here to your toolbar and make it a fill and stroke by default. That's white and black. And now we can bump up that the weight of that a little bit. That might be a little thick. Make it aligned to the outside Yeah, that's a little thick. Let's bring it down. But I think that looks perfect. And now you can change the color of the top. Make that white. And I think that looks a lot. Actually, I think that looks exactly like this one, except I added that little extra there. Established in 2014. And that was white. And I put it right there on the bottom. You can do lots of cool things. Put another little picture there, another star, more shapes, anything. But now it looks a lot like a logo, and I think that is wonderful. And now what you can do is select everything, and you can scroll it up and down and make it fit to whatever you want it to fit to. One thing I want to address here, since it is a little bit longer tutorial, a lot of people say, when I select everything and scale it down, my stroke gets really thick and it looks weird. That's really easy to fix. Up here in the Illustrator Preferences, General, you have the option to scale your strokes and effects. You can see if you don't have that checked and you scale everything down, that stroke stayed really, really thick. And if you zoom in, you can see that the stroke around that star, they got thick and it bumps into the outside and it looks terrible. So what you want to do is go to Illustrator Preferences, General, and make sure Scale Strokes and Effects is checked. And then when you size everything down, those strokes will scale down as well, and it'll keep everything in proportion. That happens a lot, and that's the easy fix to it. Okay, so there is your creating type in a circle logo. I hope that was helpful. Thanks again so much for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.